In today's session, we are going to connect your website with your Zoho CRM. That means that whenever someone on your website will fill the contact form, his information will be connected to your Zoho CRM automatically. In addition, of course, you can also get a notification that a new lead arrived, and your lead will get an email notification saying thank you very much for contacting us. First of all, we are going to Zoho CRM and we're clicking on the settings icon. And then you will need to scroll down and under developer space, you will click on web forms. That will be the easiest way. You can also connect your Zoho forms with your website, which I prefer to do it this way. But in this session, we are going to cover only Zoho CRM web forms. In order to create a web form, you will click on the right side on create web form. And from the left side, you will select the fields that will appear on the lead form. Right now, you will see that I will have last name and agent on the right side. Zoho selected those fields because those fields are mandatory in my system. If you don't know how to create fields mandatory or not mandatory, or even change their names or add new fields, please refer to my Zoho CRM course, lesson number 4, and this lesson will deal specifically with the modules and fields. In order to add more fields, you will go to the left side. Let's say that I also want to have the first name. So I will click here, first name, and I will drag and drop it to the right place. Maybe I also want to have a phone number and an email address. As a side note, just know that as the more fields that you will add to your form, the less conversion you will have. But from the other side, the more fields that you will add, you will also filter the wannabes, the one that are just spamming you and just want to get free information very fast. So, you know, you need to decide where are you in the food chain. Let's assume that agent, it's a mandatory field in my system, but I don't want to have it here. You will have two options. Option number one is to go to the modules and fields and mark this field not mandatory. This is option number one. Option number two is to click on the gear icon. Click here on mark as required field, which means it will not be required on the form. And you need to click on mark as hidden field. And then you can pre-select a value, which means every lead that will come to the system will be marked as agent no, which means it's not an agent. And then I click on done. Now you will see that this field is grayed out. On the top, you can manipulate the look and feel. Don't get excited. You won't be able to go that far with what you have here. The form will not look that good. If you have a web developer, he will probably be able to take the HTML of this form and will customize it to be a nice looking form. But from here, it will be a very, very basic form. And I will show you very soon how it looks like. Now we're clicking on next step, and here we will create the form. And let's say this form will be contact us. The form location will be where the form is going to reside. If you don't have an idea of where it's going to reside, or you have maybe multiple pages, you will just have here the star. In the landing page URL, that will be the thank you page. So let's assume that I do have a thank you page. So I will write here thank you. Let's assume that I want to redirect them to the home page. That will be the easiest because I don't really have a thank you page. So I will go back here and I will place my home page. Of course, in real life scenario, you want your users to be forwarded into a nice thank you page. And the thank you page might have additional offers or download a book or something that will create more trust with your user, and that will prepare them for the next meeting. Next, you will need to select the owner, who is going to be in charge of the lead. You have two options. Option number one is to choose a user from here, and that would be a list of all the users in your system. Another option is choosing the lead assignment rule. If you don't know what I'm talking about, refer to the course lesson number 16. Add tags will be an option to add tags to the lead, which means every lead that will come from this form can be labeled with a specific tag. Enable double opt-in means that whenever someone is sending you a lead, he will get an email back and the email will request him to confirm that he really sent it. That's a double confirmation. We can also notify the lead owner using an email that a new lead arrived. You can do it using the system generated mail, or you can create your own mail template. Mail templates will be in lesson number 11 if you don't know yet. Acknowledge visitor will send your visitor an email that will say thank you for sending the details, we'll get back to you as soon as possible, or something like that. And you will be able to or create different rules or create or select a specific email template for all of them. Of course, you can customize your template that will say a first name, which means a Lior. And then it won't be really highly customizable, but it will be good enough for this purpose. You can also turn on visitor tracking, and that will connect you with Sales IQ. If you don't know what Sales IQ is, it's a beautiful software that is tracking your users, which means whenever your user is on your website, you can know which pages they're visited, and everything is connected back to your Zoho CRM. So it's beautiful. If you have Zoho One, go and activate it, install the code and do it. It's beautiful. And the last thing is a request for approval. There is a section in Zoho CRM that it's specifically about approval process. And let me just show you where it is. One second. And here, approval process. The approval process system, it's lesson number 15. If you don't know which lesson I'm talking about, you can see here that you can create approval process. And whenever, where it is, and whenever someone is sending you a lead, it will be pending for your approval, which means they will not be added automatically as a lead. They will wait until you're going to approve them, and only then they will be released as lead. It's a great feature if you have lots of leads and some of them are spam or some of them are not qualified. So that's the way that you filter all of them. And now I have the code. So that's the HTML that you will give to your web developer. If you have, let's do two things. So let's try, I will copy this code. I will go to my website. Let me just create a dummy page. Let's go to pages. This system, by the way, is named Lead Pages, and it's an inexpensive way to create websites and create landing pages. I will create a hidden page, and let's say contact. Okay, so here, for example, and what I'm doing here, you can do with any website builder. I will click on widgets and I will have a HTML widget here. And that's something, again, I'm doing it here, but you can do it anywhere. And whenever I'm clicking on preview, you will be able to see the form. And whenever you will fill the form, now you see the form. Of course, I can customize the view, the background, and I can customize the font size. But again, it won't look good. You can see you have submit and reset. No one is using reset for a decade. So anyway, I think that this form will not convert traffic, but I think you can give this HTML to your developer and he will add some style sheet on it and it will look good. It's part of your website. So no problems here. If I will go ahead and I will fill the form and I will click submit, you will see that I'm trying to get forwarded into a page that doesn't exist. That's what I added as the thank you page. And if we are going to the lead system, you will see that I just got a new lead and the lead placed automatically into my system. Okay, now the lead status is new and my blueprint is ready to go. So that's really how you manage a web form. Before I close the session, I want to show you also how you can do it with Zoho Sites. If I'm going to Zoho Sites and I'm loading a web page, let's assume that I want to add here the form. I will click on add, I will go to forms, and then I will select the Zoho CRM form, web to lead, and that will be integrated automatically. So now you have the form. With Zoho Sites, you just need to have 3 clicks and it's already there and it's integrated with your system and it's all easy. So just so you know, you have those 2 options. You can work with the HTML and you can paste it into a website, or you can use Zoho Sites and easily connect them. Thank you very much for watching this session. If you like to take my Zoho CRM course, check the link below. I gave you a $25 off coupon. Thank you very much and have a beautiful day.